Hi guys, I'm Yaode. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to wiring the tubes for my boost tap and the turbo pressure sensor on my car, and I'm going to show you how to wiring all of those tubes. Before we start, let me show you what the tools you need. First, you need two types of the tubes for P3 turbo boost pressure sensor and boost tap from ECS tuning, and also you need this nut drive and some Z-taps, and also this is a P3 track chip, which I thought I got the track one, but actually I didn't, so I'm going to install this chip as well, and also trim removal, and this 3M tape is for the gauge. And also, as you can see, here is the boost tap from the ECS tuning, which this one is installed located at the throttle body. You also can get another one which is installed at this intake manifold and installed at here, which this one is much easier to install. This one is a pin in the S to install this, and they don't have differences in functional. Basically, we are going to wiring the tube from here, go through here, and then go through this firewall to the cabin, and then it will be come out from there, and you can just to connect this P3 gauge. Now let's restart the work. First, I'm going to take this trim off just by using this trim removal, and then I'm going to take this nut off, and also two on here, one on here, and on one here, and the size for all of these nuts is 8 millimeters. And now you just pull it out. So as you can see, this glove box is off. You just pull it out carefully, and then it will be out. The reason for this is it will be help me to go through firewall. Before we go through the firewall, let me put the track chips on. First, you have to take this cover off by pull all of these clips off. Now, as you can see, this cover is off. It's really easy. It's really nice package. Prevent the chip will be damaged. Now, as you can see, here says track pack. We only need to replace this chip, then it will be all done. Finally, it's off. Pull it out gently, and you don't want to damage all of these small pins. As you can see, here got a dot, and now this dot is facing this side. Be sure you got the right position and push it in. Make it tight, and now we can put this cover back. So right now I'm going to put the tube, go through the firewall from the engine bay, and this tube is for the P3 turbo boost sensor, and with the firewall is located at the that blue black wire there. That is the firewall. Now as you can see, this one is go through. Let me show you inside. You can see here, it goes through from the engine bay. And now I'm going to put this tube, which is for this boost tap, and the connection will be at the here, because here is not really hot. And this tube will go through from here, which here have a little bit hole, which is already pre-made from the manufacturer, so it will be easy to go through. And right now I'm going to put this port into one of these. And before you put them on, you have to use this foam to put on here to help them have a better seal. Now as you can see, this is come through at here, and here is connection, and then go through the firewall and come down inside of here. Right now I'm just going to cut the rest of this and then connect to here, and it will be all done. And right now, as you can see, I tied up all of these wires, and also I put the 3M tape at here. I'm going to tape this one on top of the glove box, and also as you can see, turbo boost sensor is already plugged in, and also I put a zip tie also on here as well to prevent it will be off. Now as you can see, this part is also all done, and here is connects through here, and I put the zip tie at here, and as you can see, it's all done. Now let me put everything back. So guys, right now it's all done. This is the boost tap. The tube come from here, goes through here, and goes through the firewall, and comes through firewall and connect to this P3 gauge. Let's restart up the car. And this right now is a code. With this code is for the catalyst converter. Now this is the boost you can see right now. And it's reading and this is the coolant, and this is the air temperature, and this is ignition, and this is the exhaust gas temperature, throttle position, and this is the RPM, and this is the speed, and this is 0 to 60 miles per hour, and right now it says it's ready, so you can just launch your car. If you are driving your car, it will let you stop the car and then will become ready. And this is the battery, and this is the air ratio. With this is not come with the normal pack, this only show up in the track pack. So I just installed that track chip today. Right now it's showing up this one. And this is the boost. And also if you got the track pack, you can also test the 100 to 200 and 100 to 0. So this will be end of this video. If you guys are planning wiring all of these tubes by yourself, then you should know how to do after this video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. Please subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram as well. Thank you for your watching. I will see you next video.